In this lecture, we are talking about two things: externally owned accounts and smart contracts, or just contracts. If you have ever sent any Bitcoins around, then you should know externally accounts already. You have a wallet. In that wallet is a private key stored. From that private key, an address is derived. With the private key in your hands, you can send coins from one address to another. This workflow is exactly the same with Ethereum as it is with Bitcoin, or any other major currency for that matter. So, you can send the assets, the coins, around. To send the Ether around, you need a private key. This key is enabling you to sign transactions. These accounts, which are bound to a private key from someone externally, are called EOAs, or externally owned accounts. But on the Ethereum blockchain, you also have another opportunity. This comes with the smart contracts. Those smart contracts live on their own address. So there are no keys behind it, just an address. On this address, there is also some programming logic. Those can be functions to store or redistribute Ether, or just store information like votes or a bank balance or a calorie counter. It can go from non-financial information to sophisticated financial data. The most famous one was the DAO, which was a distributed autonomous organization. It was a computer program running on the Ethereum blockchain, a smart contract. The idea was a new way of investing in startups. It was the very first large smart contract that got famous, but it also got hacked. But that's another story. With smart contracts, you can do a lot. For example, you could have a wallet directly on the blockchain. This wallet could store Ether and let some people draw 3 Ethers a day, or other people draw 6 Ethers a week. Just an example. I'm going to show you this with the following screencast. You will see the tool Remix that we are using a lot more, but for the sake of this example, just have a brief look and see what it can do from a workflow standpoint. So I'm here in Remix, and I will not explain now what exactly Remix is because we're doing this in a later lecture, but I want to show you an example of the difference between accounts, externally owned accounts, and smart contracts and what is possible with them. Now I'm here in a Chrome browser, and Remix is an IDE that's running directly in the browser. And in the Chrome browser, I also have a MetaMask plugin. And we're going to talk about all of this later. But what is important for you to understand is that the MetaMask plugin can store accounts like any other wallet. So it can store private keys, it can create private keys. And from these private keys, it can create the public keys. And from the public keys, it can derive the address. So in this case, I'm on the Rinkeby testnet, and I have here 4 different accounts. In my account 1, I have 9 Ether, and my account 2, account 3, and account 4 are empty. Now, if I would want to, for example, spread 3 Ether across my other 3 accounts here, let's say I want to spread 3 Ether across them, and I want to have then 1 Ether in account number 2, 1 Ether in account number 3, 1 Ether in account number 4, because I want to spread them evenly, and I want to make sure that this is always the case. I can go in here and manually go to account number 2, copy the address to clipboard, back to account number 1, hit the send button, the recipient address here, say, let's say 0.1 Ether. Hit next, submit the transaction, click here, have a look at the transaction, wait for the transaction to be mined. It's not even in the network yet. Let's see, now it's pending. And in a few seconds, the transaction should be mined and the 0.1 Ether should be reflected in the other account. Now the transaction is mined. It's in this block and it has this transaction hash. So let's have a look. Our balance is decreased here, and in our account number 2 we have 0.1 Ether. Now I could do the same with account number 3
and account number 4. But with Solidity, I can also deploy a smart contract on the Ethereum blockchain and then have the smart contract do different kinds of things for me. One thing, for example, is spread money, spread Ether around, because we both have the code and we have the assets, the Ethers, running on the same blockchain, on the same system. Now, it can do a lot more, but in this case, I just want to go with a very, very simplistic example. I have one function here, and the function takes whatever is sent to this contract. It's stored in this message value object. And then it has my three accounts. I copied them directly from the MetaMask plugin here. I went in account number 2, copy address to clipboard. Account number 3, copy address to clipboard. Account number 4, copy address to clipboard. So account number 2 would be 1. Account number 3 here would be 2. Account number 3 would be 3. And then I basically just transfer 1/3 of everything to 1, 2, and 3. And that's totally, entirely running on the blockchain. So once it's deployed, I cannot change anything on that anymore. So everybody who is sending money to this contract can be certain that it's really sent to these three addresses and not afterwards changed to anything else. Now let's give it a try. Just reloading this page. So I select my contract here, example 1, and hit the create button. MetaMask will pop up. I submit this and I have to wait for this transaction to be mined. So maybe important to understand is everything on Ethereum works within transaction, especially if you write data to the blockchain. And in this case, we have to wait until the transaction is mined. Now the transaction is mined and I can see here on the lower side, my contract instance is now available. I'm going to send now 0.3 Ether to this contract. And then let's see what happens. Let's open this Ethereum transaction here on Etherscan. It should be incorporated in the blockchain in a second. Now it's incorporated. So it's in our block 1,981,273. Let's have a look. Our balance here is lowered because we sent money to the contract. So we didn't send it to the addresses directly. We sent money to a contract that sits on his own address on the blockchain. And then let's have a look in account number 2. We have 0.1 Ether more here. In account number 3, we have 0.1 Ether more than before. That was 0. And in account 4, we have 0.1 Ether more. That was 0 before as well. Now again, I want to show you that the address of the contract is not... I'll just copy and paste it here. The address of the contract, which is on the blockchain really deployed, has something to do with the address of our first account. It's pre-generated with the account, with the address of the account and the nonce, but it lives really on its own address. And everybody, you could go in the Rinkeby testnet now and send Ether to this address. And everything that you will send will be distributed amongst those three addresses evenly. You can find those example, or this example in particular, also in our GitHub repository. And the file is going to be example 1, x1, Solidity file. And I'll see you in the next lecture.
This is incredibly powerful. Now, assets like Ether are managing themselves without any middleman. You don't need to hire someone to make sure your kids are not emptying your pockets. If the logic is baked in a smart contract, then it's considered safe and unhackable. So now you know the difference between externally owned accounts and smart contracts.